I've been thinking about something I remember JoJo Mayer saying in an interview or a clinic that I heard a long time ago, and I hope I'm not paraphrasing too much, but the gist of what he was saying was he was talking about the mix on stage when you're playing live never being quite right and never quite feeling comfortable on stage, whether it's not enough kick in your monitors or not being able to hear one of the other instruments. He was basically talking about flying all over the world and doing all these clinics and performances with Nerve and the sound never quite being right. And that always stuck with me because I had had that experience, and I'm sure many of you have had this experience of, you know, getting to a venue and even after sound check, or even, you know, especially if you don't have a sound check, getting up there and it feels like either the snare is thin or you can't hear the vocals or something about the sound is not quite right and it makes you uncomfortable and it makes it difficult to play. And so I thought it was interesting him mentioning this because I thought, oh, you know, JoJo Mayer flies all over the world, you know, is one of the best drummers of all time, and even he still has these problems. And I also remember Gil Sharon saying something about this in, I think, Modern Drummer Fest 2010. He spends a good chunk of his time talking about making sure you're comfortable on stage. And I've had a couple of these experiences lately of, you know, a monitor mix not being quite right. And the thing I noticed was that it was affecting my playing. And I was talking to the singer of one of these groups, and he was talking about similarly not getting enough vocals in his monitors. And because of that, he was over singing. And I thought of that and realized that I'd been doing the same thing, or oftentimes, you know, in certain venues, I'll do the same thing. If I'm not getting enough of something, or if I feel like the snare's too thin, or whatever it might be, I will overplay. And for me, oftentimes that'll make it tough for me to play like certain licks or certain things that I'm comfortable playing at what I feel is a good dynamic in the practice room, but then on stage, something feels off and suddenly my playing is affected. So Gil's point about all of this that it took me until now to really appreciate is that you need to make sure that you are comfortable and that when you're playing, you feel comfortable regardless of how you perceive it is sounding to the audience. Because so often, the on-stage balance is completely different than what it sounds like to the audience. And especially if you're close mic'd, the sound person, they have a job to do, leveling and balancing your kit, and they're going to do it. So if you start overplaying because it seems like the snare is thin or like you can't hear your toms, or suddenly it seems like your toms are out of tune, if you start playing differently or overplaying or underplaying, it's gonna make it that much harder for the sound person to balance that mix, especially when you've already sound checked a certain way. So, again, Gil's point was that you need to have the muscle memory, not only of what you're gonna play, but how it feels to play at a balanced dynamic and to replicate that on stage regardless of what you're hearing, which can kind of trip you up because you might feel like you're not getting any kick and so you're kicking really hard to overcompensate, but suddenly you can't play those quick doubles and suddenly it, you know, the kick is sliding on you because you're overcompensating and you're not letting the sound person do their job while you are doing your job. This is a lesson that, again, like I said, I'm only now coming to fully appreciate, and I think the best way to practice this is to take the Benny Greb method of balancing yourself in the practice room, which is just to take one mic, and that could be your phone or just one microphone, and put it either in front of the kit or just over the top of the kit, or put it where, you know, someone else would be standing near the kit, and then play in a way that feels and sounds balanced to one microphone. And once you find how you need to play in order to sound good and balanced to one mic, that is how you should play on stage. Regardless of what room you're in, regardless if you're close mic'd or you only have an overhead, you should always be playing so that the drum set is balanced just as an acoustic instrument. And then the microphones and the sound person can do their job. So again, like I said, this is a lesson that I'm coming to appreciate just as much as anyone else, and hopefully it's helpful to some of you as well. See you in the next one.